I have the Samsung Galaxy S23 here, and in today's video, I'll be showing you how to enable a feature that allows you to hide the entire navigation bar while it's not in use. This feature will keep the three-button nav bar in place, so we aren't switching to gesture navigation here. Instead, we're going to enable an auto-hide feature that makes the navigation bar down here disappear until we swipe up from the bottom of the screen to reveal it. But before we get to that guide, let's talk a bit about today's sponsor. PlayStoreFinder.com is a website geared toward helping you find the best Android apps and games available in the Google Play Store. Some of us are tired of dealing with the junk apps and games being promoted, while the true gems are left buried among millions of options. Play Store Finder lets you browse through entire categories or game and app genres, and then use the built-in filter system to zero in on exactly what you're interested in. So maybe you're looking for a game that supports the controller. We can use that filter to only show games that support using a gamepad controller. And then it will filter out every game in a category or a genre that does not support it. Then maybe you want a game that also does not require an internet connection. So we can go in here and choose offline support. Then we can use that filter as well. And the best part, you can see that the active filters stick. So we can combine filters so that we're only looking at games with controller support that do not require an internet connection. So visit www.playstorefinder.com and share your thoughts down in the comment section below. Now, back to learning how to hide the navigation bar on Samsung Galaxy devices. In order to enable this feature, we must first have the GoodLock application installed. This app was downloaded from the Galaxy App Store, but if you aren't able to find it, or if you aren't familiar with what GoodLock is and how its modules work, then check the video description below for a link to a dedicated introductory video that I did on this application. Now, once the application has been installed, let's open it up and then install the NavStar module if you haven't done so already. Then we can open up NavStar by tapping on it and then make sure that it is enabled by tapping on the toggle up here at the top. This toggle will be disabled by default, but you can see we can turn it on with a simple tap. We're going to look on this page, we're going to scroll through and look for the Show and Hide button, as there will be a toggle right next to it as well. This toggle will be disabled by default too, but again, just like before, we can turn it on with a quick tap. And once the Show and Hide button has been enabled, you will see a dot appear next to the navigation bar on Samsung Galaxy devices. This dot here is the Show and Hide button, and we can trigger it with a double tap. So even though the feature is enabled here, the navigation bar is going to stay in place until we double tap on that button. Once we double tap on that Show and Hide button, you can see the navigation bar instantly hides. And we can bring it back with a swipe up from the bottom of the screen. That navigation bar will only stay visible for a short while, as it will auto-hide again after a few seconds. So if you are a fan of the three-button navigation bar, but would like apps and games to take up the entire screen, then enabling this show and hide button and actively hiding the navigation bar is a great alternative to the gesture navigation feature. Now, personally, I prefer the gesture navigation option on Android, but if you aren't a fan, then you still have this feature. We also have a way to keep the navigation bar visible while we're viewing the One UI home screen with this toggle here. So if that's something you want, you can keep that turned on, but we can disable that as well if you would like to keep the navigation bar hidden on the home screen. NavStar is a great little module for the GoodLock application that gives us some unique options related to the navigation bar. And I highly recommend you check it out if you own a Samsung Galaxy smartphone or tablet.